Hello, welcome to my channel. It's been a long time since I've done a video. My life kind of got a little hectic for a while and it's finally calmed down a little bit that I feel like I have time to do my videos again. So I'm very excited. Today's video, I want to talk about my favorite books of 2022 or my best books of 2022. Now, some of these books were released in 2022, but some of them are backlist books, which means basically that they're books that came out prior to the year of 2022. They're just books that I have read this past year that I really enjoyed. Now, let's go ahead and get into the books. So I kind of had a hard time this year trying to decide what my favorite books of 2022 were, just because I read quite a few books this year compared to what I have read in past years. And sometimes it's hard to remember absolutely everything that I've read. So I kind of went through my list on Goodreads of books that I've read this year and just picked ones that kind of stood out to me that I either really remembered things that happened in them or I remember just really enjoying the book while I was reading them. And some of them I even can't get off my mind to this day. I'm constantly thinking about these books. I'm so excited to get into them with you. I do have them in order from all the way to my 10th most liked book, all the way up to 1. Anyway, I'm talking too much. Let's go ahead and get into it. The book that is in 10th place is The Gilded Cage by Lennet Nani, and this is the second book in the Prison Healer trilogy. Prison Healer follows Kiva, and she is sent to a prison called Zalandov, and she's there for 10 years. Now, she went there as a very young girl, so she grew up in this place, and it's very interesting to kind of see what she kind of learned, like the ins and outs of the prison. So that in and of itself in the first book is very interesting. So that whole book takes place in one location, which I think is very interesting because you get to see the intricacies of that prison. And I think that's why a lot of people love that book as well. But for me, it got a kind of boring in some parts, but I loved that first book enough that I really wanted to pick up the second one. And I'm glad I did because I absolutely loved this book. In this book, we meet a lot of new characters, and I think the author did a fantastic job of creating these characters and letting us know their personalities. And I get really attached to quite a few of the characters in here that I very much enjoyed. And we also learn more of the intricacies of the power system or the magic system in this trilogy as well. This book just has everything in it that you'd want. It has romance, it has action, there's high stakes, and there's also lots of humor in it, and I absolutely loved this book. Now, coming in 9th place is Where the Lost Wander by Amy Harmon. Now, my sister actually picked this book out for our family book club that we do every month, and I'm so glad that she did, because otherwise I wouldn't have even heard of this book, but this book was my saving grace and got me out of a huge reading slump. I think I went several months without reading a single book. Just nothing sounded good to me. So when I picked this up, I tell you, I could not put this down. Now, this was after me not being interested in any kind of book, and this got me hooked, and I'm absolutely glad that my sister brought this book to my attention. It's so good. We follow Naomi May and John Lowry in this book, and it's on the Overland Trail, but they're traveling out west, and Naomi is freshly widowed, and she never thought at such a young age that she would be widowed, so she's kind of trying to figure out what her life is going to look at this point. And John Lowry is a half Pawnee man, and he's kind of on the outskirts of things. He's on the outskirts of the people that he's traveling with because he's half Pawnee, and he's on the outskirts of any of the indigenous people that he meets because he's half white. So he's kind of trying to figure out what his place is in the world too, and they come together, him and Naomi, and they kind of build this relationship. And it's just so neat because this book isn't just a romance. The romance is a very small part to this book. A big part of the book is just the travel west, and they're very detailed about how, where they're traveling, the things that they run into, and they run into different Native American tribes. It made me want to pick up another Western sometime soon, so I hope that I'm able to find one to read. Now, coming in 8th place for me is The Gilded Ones by Mina Forna. Now, when this was about to come out, I was so excited for this book, and then it came out, and then I said I was going to read it, and it took me a little while to get to this book, but once I did, I was glad that I did because it was so good. It was so different from what I've read before. I thought that it was really interesting kind of magical properties in the book. Like, there's magic, but not at the same time. it's just very interesting. So girls in this world, once they turn 16, they do this like blood rate. And if their blood turns red, then they're pure. If their blood turns gold, then they're impure. The girls with the gold blood have two options. The first one is they could stay in their village and be killed. Or the second option, which really there's no option at all in this situation, is to go and fight for the emperor against their enemies. So Deka, our 16-year-old girl who had gold blood, decided to go and fight for the emperor. But once again, not really a decision. She either had to stay and die or go fight for the emperor and fight his enemies. So really not an option there. So she goes to fight for the emperor, learns how to fight, meets new people here. But then she realizes that not everything is as it seems. So this story is so interesting. I really like the magic system that's in here because, like I said, it's not necessarily magic as you would think magic is. One of the big things that I liked in this story was that the majority of the main characters are all female, and they're all strong females who have different issues that they have to overcome, but they end up working together, and I really liked that in this story. I really liked that they came together like that, even though that they were all from different parts of the world, and they all had came from different families and had different issues. I just liked how they came together and worked together about it, and I liked a lot of the big reveals in this book as well. I absolutely loved this book. I loved the strong female characters and all the action, and it was just different than all the things that I've read before. So definitely if you're interested in a book that has all those things, this is the one for you. So coming in number 7 for me is Fury Song by Rosaria Munda, and this is the third book in the Fireborn trilogy. It is the third and final book, and let me tell you, this is the way to end a series. This was the best last book in a series or a trilogy that I've ever read before, and I absolutely loved it. It was great. Just the whole series had great political stuff, had lots of action. Obviously, it's about dragons. This book was just so good. So the first one follows Annie and Lee, our two main characters, and they both come from very different backgrounds, and they become dragon riders in this new regime, in this new political regime in this world. So in this world, it used to be run by dragon lords who basically had servants or slaves. Not a good situation. And that this new regime is all about a republic, about people coming together. And there's not everyone gets to vote, but there's more of a process of things going through. Not one person decides everything or is above everyone. So people have to take this test, and they're ranked on where they are on the scale. Like, can they go to become a dragon rider, or are they going to work as a merchant? That kind of stuff. The test kind of puts you in the place in this world where they think you will best fit. And so the story is very political, which I really liked about this whole trilogy. Sometimes I think with political stories, you can get kind of boring, but this story had enough action in it and some other things that go along with the plot that kept me interested. This third book was the best ending to a series I have ever read. It just brought everything together, and it didn't necessarily give everything a happy ending or tied everything up in a nice pretty bow, because honestly, in real life, that doesn't happen. Not everything ends up in a happy ending. Not everything works out the way you want it to work out. Sometimes there are other things that come into play. And in this story, Rosaria Munda does a good job of giving happy endings where they need to be, giving open endings where they need to be, and also kind of putting not so happy endings in other places, because that's just realistic, especially in this world where there's lots of politics, there's lots of things going on, there's wars going on. She just did a great job with the story, and definitely if Rosaria Munda comes out with her next book, I'll definitely be picking it up, because I just think she did a great job with this whole trilogy. Coming in at number 6 is The Ballad of Never After by Stephanie Gerber. Now this book really surprised me, because this is the second book in the Once Upon a Broken Heart trilogy, I think it's going to be. And I liked Once Upon a Broken Heart. It was okay. I gave it 3 stars. It was an okay book. It read really young for me. It was interesting. Like, I liked how whimsical the world was. But it definitely wasn't like a fantastic book. I'm like, oh, I gotta pick up the second one. I gotta do it. I gotta read it right now. Now, I did pick up the second one because the first one was cute. It's a cute little world. I thought it'd be interesting to read the second one. And so I got this. I waited a little while before I picked it up to read it. But when I picked this up, I tell you, this was like a completely different book of like tone compared to the first one. I felt like personally, it's still whimsical world, but I felt like it read a little bit older. And I don't know if the author meant to do that because of the things that the main character has gone through, that she's kind of grown a little bit maybe, but definitely an older tone to this book. And I just liked the plot a lot more in this one. I liked the character's dynamic in this a lot more too. So I'm not sure what changed from book one to two, but I absolutely love this one. I believe I gave this 5 stars because I loved it so much, and now I'm like, I gotta pick up that third one. I need the third one right now. In the first book, we follow Evangeline Fox, and she is asked to go up north, and she goes up there, and it's kind of a very whimsical world up there, and they think that she is this key to unlock the Valerie Arch. Jax, who is from the first trilogy that Stephanie Garber wrote, which is Caraval, which I have not read yet, but after reading this one, I'm definitely gonna read it now. But Jax wants to use Evangeline to open this Valerie Arch. And their dynamic is very interesting in the first one. She's rather irritated with him all the time, which is kind of funny. And he is like, needs to use her, but he's also irritated with her too. So their whole dynamic is very interesting. But in this book, their dynamic grows a lot more. And I really enjoy that in here. Or in the second book too, which I enjoy. I really loved this book and I can't wait for the next one to come out. Now my next 5 are all from the same series, but I will still put them in order of my favorites for you. Now, a lot of you probably have heard of this series, and the series is so popular right now, and I kind of knew about it before it got popular, and I was somewhat interested in it, but like not like, oh, I want to pick this up and read this right away. And then it got really popular, and I was kind of annoyed with how much people were talking about it. I'm like, oh my gosh, this book series cannot be that fantastic. But then I finally picked it up this past year, and let me tell you, these are the books that I literally cannot get out of my mind. I'm constantly thinking about these books, and I read the first one like 6-7 months ago, a long time ago, and I still can't get it out of mind. I'm constantly thinking about these books. And so I get where the hype is coming from for this book series, though a lot of you might roll your eyes at the fact that these are my favorites for this year, but they just are. I cannot stop thinking about these books. I absolutely love them. So coming in at 5 is A Court of Silver Flames by Sarah J. Maas. And this is the latest book in the A Court of Thorns and Roses series. Follows Nesta and Cassian. We get to know her a little bit more. She's kind of unlikable in the first few books, but I feel like in this book we get to know more why she is the way she is, because it's her inner monologue and her story. So I thought that was really interesting. We got to get back into the world that a lot of us love so much and get to know more about some of the other characters and further their stories along. It was just really good. I liked a lot of the fantasy elements in this book as well. There was kind of some, I wouldn't say a whole lot of action in this book, but there was a lot of planning and hard work going into the final action scenes towards the end of the book that I really thought was interesting. And talking about me liking female characters coming together to work together, this book has that, and I really enjoyed that because sometimes I feel like, especially in fantasy romances, it's all about the romance. It's all about the female main character and the male main character. So I do like it when there are a group of women that come together and work together, and it's more than just about the romance. There's a little bit more to it than just the romance between the main characters. So I really liked that about this book. So anyway, this is 5 on my favorites list. Now, 4 on my favorites list is A Court of Wings and Ruins by Sarah J. Maas. Now, I think for this book, I believe I gave it 3 stars. But I think I gave it 3 stars because I was comparing it to, obviously, the other books in the series that I've read so far. And this book just was really slow at points. And I think I've heard this from other people as well, that once you get to a certain point in this book, it just kind of gets slow and repetitive. Like, there are portions of this book that probably don't need to be in here. But overall, if I had to compare this, obviously it's on my favorites list, if I had to compare this to a lot of other books that I've read, I still love this book. like I probably could get a give it a higher rating, but I rated it compared to the other books in this series. Anyways, moving on. So this is the third book in the A Court of Thorns and Roses series. The first three books follow Feyre, who is the sister of Nesta. So in the first book of the series, which is A Court of Thorns and Roses, Feyre and her sisters are in the human realm, and the humans hate the Fae. Because of the war that was, I think, like 500 years ago, they just dislike them a lot, and Feyre grew up learning all these things. So she goes in the woods hunting and finds a Fae and kills him. So then she is forced to go into the Fae realm to kind of make up for killing a Fae. And then it just spirals from there. So this is the first book is a Beauty and the Beast retelling. And I will say, this one is a lot different than the next two. So this first one is kind of its own story. And then the other two just kind of add on to this one and create another story. But this book is a little slow at first because it's trying to tell you the world, trying to explain the magic systems of things and trying to build up to it. Then there starts to be a lot more action in this, and I really enjoyed the action in it. This book just has some political stuff in it, has romance, has some family drama in it as well. And it's just really good. I enjoyed this one a lot. Obviously, it made me want to pick up the other ones. But I will say this book also made me very emotional towards the end. And it's still a really good book. This was number three for me. This is number two. So if you've read the series before, as you can guess, my number one most favorite book of 2022 was A Court of Mist and Fury by Sarah J. Maas. And this is the second book in the A Court of Thorns and Roses series. The best book. This is the book I think about the most. I absolutely love this book. I even got page overlays for it from the Reading Portal if you want to check them out. They're really good. So here's one of the page overlays for it. But I never thought I'd like get this kind of stuff from my books, but I love this book so much. I wanted the artwork in there just of the really fun scenes. So such a good book. It expands on the Fae realm more, and we see more sides of Feyre. We see more sides of the male main character from the first book, and we get a new main male character in this book, which we all know we like him better than the first one. But this book is so, so good. I can't say much about this book without spoilers, so I won't say much more about it, but so good. I love this book so much. I know people rave about this series all the time, but it is well worth the praise. It is so good. So those are my top 10 best books of 2022. Let me know down below if any of those books were on your favorites list of the year, and I'd love to hear what you have to say about them. Even if you didn't like these books, I'm interested to see what your opinions on them are as well. Thank you guys so much for watching today. Once again, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon if you want to be notified when I post new content. I'll see you next time. Bye.